Pro Group Management. Workers' comp that works for you.
Welcome to Nevada Newsmakers. On the broadcast today, Majority Floor Leader Assemblywoman Teresa Benitez-Thompson joins us for the whole show on an all-new Nevada Newsmakers.
Hello, is this D&D Roofing?
Yes, it is. How may I help you?
You did such a great job on my roof. May I speak to the owner?
I am an owner.
Oh, can I speak to your supervisor?
Sure.
How may I help you?
I love your work. May I speak to the owner?
I am an owner. We're all owners. Well, that's why at D&D we work so hard to keep your home safe and sound.
Oh, no wonder.
D&D Roofing and Sheet Metal. Local, employee-owned, here for you.
Retail's impact on Nevada's economy? Enormous. 8,600 businesses, large and small, employing 145,000 workers. And last fiscal year, retail paid tax on nearly $60 billion in sales. We're the Retail Association of Nevada. We support retail. We help it grow. And we mean business.
RANNV.org.
Pro Group Management offers workers' comp services to a growing number of industries. As businesses grow and change with the times, the need for a solid workers' comp program must be flexible and up to date. The evolving nature of regulations can make staying ahead of complex tasks challenging. But Pro Group Management simplifies the work so your industry can move forward and succeed. Pro Group Management. Workers' comp that works for you.
This is Nevada Newsmakers with host Sam Shad, a no-holds-barred political forum. Now, from the Nevada Newsmakers broadcast headquarters, here is Sam Shad.
And back on Nevada Newsmakers, we are always delighted to welcome back to the program Assemblywoman Teresa Benitez-Thompson. She's the Majority Floor Leader. It is a pleasure to have you back on the program.
Hello, Sam. Good morning. It's good to be here.
We're taping this on the 13th of January, so people know what the time frame is. And I wanted to ask you, you have a whole bunch of kids in your house. What have you been telling them about what happened last Wednesday?
Well, I have two who are in middle school, my older two, Lily and Eli. So we actually watched a lot of the coverage together and had hours of conversation about what was happening. They are both in really great history classes where they've been discussing a lot of these topics. My son is knee deep in studying the Constitution right now. And so as a parent, just to hear some of the educational Zooms that he's doing and how educators are wrapping those conversations into their classroom discussions, I think has been really, really good because I think I've seen them do more thinking from different types of perspectives about the incident than maybe some other people have, or sometimes more than I've hear adults talk about it. You know, you can have some pretty knee-jerk reactions or very emotional reactions, which I think are absolutely in line and expected for what we saw. But then talking with the kids and seeing how they continue to talk about it in their classrooms and how that conversation has changed and different things that they talk about, different perspectives. I think it was really actually quite good for me to hear them talk about the Constitution and talk about our country and talk about our values and talk about what is important. And then just hear from their own perspectives of being 13 and 12, when they look at that and they see what adults are doing, you know, their impressions of it as well. So we talked for hours about it.
And what was your biggest takeaway?
My biggest takeaway just of the events from last week or the takeaway conversation?
From the kids. Because the kids are going to grow up with this. This is going to be a moment in history for them and that they have lived through and that they will remember, especially at that age. So are you taking away from them an optimism for them for the future, a pessimism? What are you taking away from them?
For me, it was really my takeaway was they get that we are a country that is constantly going to be having conversations about in all different kinds of way, about fairness and equity, about who feels like they are being acknowledged within American culture and who feels like they are not being acknowledged in American culture, the legitimacy of some of those claims and the non-legitimacy of some of them. So I took away from the fact that we've got some smart kids out there who really think about this deeper than we would have thought. And not only that, but the biggest thing that we talked about and that we watched was when the Congress reconvened. And I think it was my son or my daughter, one of them said, and I thought it was so poignant, like, this is what America is. It's not that we have the strife, because every country has strife. It's not that we have these conflicts and these tensions, because we've had conflicts and tensions throughout our history in America. It's that we came back to the representative democratic process. We came right back to it. They reconvened. And to me, for me, it was very heartfelt to know that that was their takeaway, that you come back to the core principles of what this country is founded on, and you keep moving through the process.
Let's take a break. We'll come back more with Assemblywoman Teresa Benitez-Thompson after this timeout.
What do you count on? You count on your power every day. At NV Energy, we've always powered what's important to you, but we're not looking at the past. We're focused on the future. While our standards are high, our rates will remain low. And our commitment to renewables isn't just meeting standards, but leading the way. Because you can count on more than just your power. You can count on the company who brings it to you. That's our promise. You can count on it.
Because of UMC, I'm putting my free time to good use.
Because of UMC, she keeps me on my toes.
Because of UMC and this guy, I'm here.
UMC, the highest level of care in Nevada.
Get in on the action at the Tamarack Casino and win your share of $100,000 guaranteed. Now through February 27th, plus 5x points every Friday. $100,000 guaranteed at Tamarack Casino. Your good times are at Tamarack.
Enjoy exceptional value and a comfortable atmosphere at Reno's newest steakhouse, Nevada Steak.
Ooh, your good times at Tamarack.
Your good times are at Tamarack Casino.
This is Nevada Newsmakers.
And back on Nevada Newsmakers, we continue our conversation with Assemblywoman Teresa Benitez-Thompson. She is the majority floor leader. So after talking about the response from your kids, now you're about to head into a legislative session. How do you approach this when you have so many opposing views going into this session about what happened in the presidential election? After 9/11, I was watching a video last night of Republicans, Democrats from the Congress standing on the steps of the Congress singing God Bless America together. No Republicans, Democrats, just Americans. How do you feel it's going to be at the legislature?
I keep encouraging resilience, that we are going to meet, we are going to have a 120-day session. There might be some interruptions due to different reasons. We might not move as quickly as we have in the past. If we have legislators or staff members who end up quarantined, you might see a slowdown in our pace. But ultimately, we are going to meet, and we're going to come together, and we're going to fulfill our constitutional obligation to pass a balanced budget. And this, the legislature since statehood has had that responsibility, regardless of everything that's been happening in the world around them. And so, I don't. In some ways, we're not this is no different than many sessions. We have lots of protests. We are used to having the protest. We are very cognizant of the fact that there's a heightened level of concern just because there is a heightened level of threat. And so we will make sure that the building is safe for legislators. We will make sure that it is safe for our staff. And then we'll go about our business because we just have to. That's our job, and we have to put doing that job first.
All right. So obviously money is the number one topic at the session and balancing the budget. What are your major concerns? What's keeping you up at night in terms of what you're going to have to do regarding the budget?
I think that I really hoped that as a legislator, I wouldn't have to face a session again where you are forced to make reductions in budgets. And that when I was first elected in my first session in 2011, that's what we had to do. It was all about cuts because we had to reduce budgets across the board. And it was, no one gets elected thinking, I'm going to go in and take away resources from people who need them. I don't think that there's anyone, Democrat or Republican, who says that's my intent when I go down to legislate. I think I'm going to help people by, you know, taking away their, you know, the amount of money we can spend on Meals on Wheels and the amount of money that we can spend on social services. And so it is a very hard place to kind of be in, but we have to look at the budget and make the best decisions we can with the least impact of harm. And during the special session over the summer, had very much the same similar mind frame that how can we do this without causing too much harm? And we have to think about protecting our most vulnerable populations. So that's where you saw us prioritize keeping in programs in the Medicaid system. So one of the options, for example, was to end the prosthetic program for Medicaid recipients. And we just couldn't do that. We were not going to take away that service. And instead, what we ended up doing was an across the board rate cut of 6% to providers. And that's a hard decision because we know we have one of the lowest Medicaid rates to providers in the nation, and that we were taking a not great rate and turning it into an even worse rate. Our providers have been wonderful. Our medical providers have been absolutely wonderful, and that they're still taking and accepting Medicaid patients, but we can't expect them to have this rate place forever. And so I know that I'm one where I'm absolutely advocating for us to reinstate that rate, at least a larger portion if we can, to ensure that providers keep taking Medicaid patients and that our Medicaid population has access to health care.
The governor, as you know, asked for 12% cuts from agencies across the board. Do you think that's how it's going to play out, or do you think it's going to, it's going to come from one place or other rather than across the board?
I think the good first approach is to look at it across the board and see what that looks like. I think that once we receive the budget on the legislative side, it makes sense for us to take a look at that and then see where it makes the most sense to augment some of those numbers and where it makes the most sense to adjust some of those numbers. So the Ways and Means Committee, at least on the years that I've been serving on it, has always taken the governor's recommended budget, but then changed it to fit a little bit to what we saw were important needs. So a good example of that would be under the Sandoval administration in 2017, we took a different approach on how to fund mental health. And we put more money into the state's mental health system than what was in the governor's recommended budget. In the 2019 session, the last session that we had, we did quite a bit of different changes within the governor's recommended budget and did some different things in education and where dollars were flowing in education. So I imagine this session will be the same, that we'll get the budget, we'll look at it, but but as, you know, our own independent sovereign body, but make changes as we see necessary. And as, you know, so I imagine we will probably have some different thoughts about that, just straight 12% across the board.
Okay, so are taxes on the table for you at all? An increase in taxes? Are increases in taxes right now? Mining and gaming have targets on their backs. Are you anticipating potentially raising any taxes from your personal point of view?
Well, I know that there are many groups out there that want us to have a conversation about increased revenue before we have a conversation about a reduction in services because we have a reduced budget. And that makes a lot of sense. However, I think that with this particular session and with only 120 days and knowing that we're gonna have some slowdowns if we have folks quarantined, because that's what happened during our special session. So I imagine that would happen during a regular session, that we might not have as much time as we typically do to indulge in those kinds of conversations. In terms of the political landscape, neither one of our houses, the Senate or the Assembly, has a 3/4 majority to pass this such a bill on our own. And so it would really be up to our Republican colleagues to say, we want to join you in a conversation about growing the resources of the state so that we don't have to cut education, or that we don't have to cut Medicaid, or so that we can have enough money on hand to restore our provider rates. And so I think it'll be interesting to see who steps forward to join us in that conversation.
Do you think with the state of the gaming industry as it stands today, major properties on the strip, being shut down during midweek because of lack of convention business, and the likelihood that if we're lucky, convention business might start coming back mid to the end of 2021, that it makes any sense to try and raise taxes from them at this point? I'm not saying ever, but at this point?
That doesn't seem to make any sense to me at this point. I don't think that conversation ends up being one that really plays out.
Let me ask you about access, because this has been a big discussion point on Nevada Newsmakers with both members of the public and lobbyists, both on the air and privately, that there's great concern that what happened in the special session with meetings at 1 o'clock in the morning and limited access, no access to the building, but limited access even for comment, et cetera. Are we going to see something different happening during the regular session where both the public, and because we're a citizens legislature, it sounds easy to say, hey, you know, if we don't have the lobbyists in, they're great because now we can actually do the people's work. But the truth of the matter is, with the citizens legislature, you need the honest lobbyists, and the only ones that succeed are the honest ones, to give you both sides of the story. So do you perceive that access will increase for both the public and the lobbying corps?
I hope so. I think that is definitely the spirit of which the conversations are happening about session. I know that Speaker Frierson has been committed to engaging the Republican leadership in the Assembly as well for input and thought, so that we can make sure that it's a holistic conversation between the two caucus leadership structures to think about what's going to be best and what's going to be how we're going to proceed. We have to think about it not only as accessibility, but safety for those who are in the building, which includes our staff as well. So we're employers, and we have to think about the staff in the building and how we keep them safe. But we certainly want to make sure that we are providing an abundance of ways for the public or registered lobbyists, for stakeholders to be able to engage with us. And special sessions are, my experience is that no, I have never heard really anyone say wonderful things about any special session that's happened in recent history. And the ones I've been a part of have always been tough. It is not a regular legislative session. You don't have regular committee hearings. You don't have a breadth of different types of opinions and amendments because being offered because you're coming in to do one thing, and there's all of this political leverage laying on legislators to make one thing happen at a special session. So I know that this past special session was very hard, and I know it was hard on the public. It was hard on legislators to be having late night meetings. It felt like every day was a signee die day during this past special session. But we were trying to work as hard as we could, 15 hours a day in order to essentially revise the entire state's budget. So that last 2 weeks of session where you have long hours and your meetings are happening quickly, that's just what that special session felt like. And for those who have been around you, you know that you can have in the session 15-hour days that we try to work hard, but hopefully the public will understand too as well that if we only worked from 8 to 5, then we wouldn't get things done as quickly. We kind of have to burn the midnight oil sometimes.
All right, let's take one more break, and we'll be right back with Assemblywoman Teresa Benitez-Thompson after this.
Get in on the action at the Tamarack Casino and win your share of $100,000 guaranteed. Now through February 27th, plus 5x points every Friday. $100,000 guaranteed at Tamarack Casino. Your good times are at Tamarack.
I can't do it. Stupid, like my mom.
We can't do anything at Mommy's because you won't pay child support.
Dad said you cheated, and he's not even sure he's my dad.
Mommy said you left both of us. So she isn't gonna let me see you.
I look just like my father.
I'm divorce attorney Marilyn York, and I may represent men, but hate has no gender, only casualties. Please, stop sacrificing your children in your war against your ex.
Everyone is talking about opioids, but they're not the only drugs that can be harmful if taken in large quantities or not as prescribed. You also need to be aware of side effects from anxiety drugs, muscle relaxants, sleep aids, and stimulants. Mixing prescription drugs with other drugs or alcohol can be dangerous. If you take Ambien with a glass of wine, it may be enough to stop you from breathing. Prescribed drugs can be just as dangerous as illegal drugs. Take medications only as directed.
Get in on the action at the Tamarack Casino and win your share of $100,000 guaranteed. Now through February 27th, plus 5x points every Friday. $100,000 guaranteed at Tamarack Casino. Your good times are at Tamarack.
This is Nevada Newsmakers.
And back on Nevada Newsmakers, we continue our conversation with Assemblywoman Teresa Benitez-Thompson. She's the majority floor leader. Have you heard from the LCB at this point about whether you'll all be allowed back into the building, the legislative building, or my understanding is that you have to be in Carson City, but you could be doing things via Zoom. Am I correct on this?
So that is correct. So the legal division of LCB interprets the Constitution to say that we are required to meet in the state's capital, but it doesn't necessarily mean that we all have to be present and on the floor, that we can just be in the Capitol. And so that those kinds of conversations were ones that we were having to figure out how we could operate in the assembly safely. And also at the time, trying to keep within the governor's required gathering limits. So if you remember over the summer, we were at a place where you could not have more than 50 people gather. And in the assembly, we have 42 people. And then we have our chief clerk staff. So we only had room for 8 additional people to be in the assembly chambers so that we weren't violating that 50 person gathering limit. And we wanted to make sure that we had media in our upper gallery because we thought, well, if we can't have public and lobbyists here, we absolutely need the media to be in here so that information can get out to the public. So, you know, we're very much watching what is happening with the COVID numbers. We're very much watching to see the environment in which we're going to be going into session. I was hoping that we would be in a better place where it would be an absolute no-brainer to say, open the doors, the public can come in and we're fine. We've got this COVID thing under control, but that's not where we are. And so we will be meeting in Carson City, legislators will be there, and we want it to look as normal as possible, but we might have to start off virtual with the building closed, or letting us only a certain amount of people into the building from the public on a first come first serve basis. There's lots of different things that we're considering right now. And I know we're going to have an answer for the public soon about what session will look like.
And sadly, we're out of time. I thank you so much for your time this morning. I really appreciate it. And hopefully we'll get to talk during session. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
And we'll be right back.
Brian Culpa Photography was born in the rolling hills of Massachusetts, and now he can help you experience the stunning beauty of Nevada in a whole new way through the power of flight. Flying has always been a passion for Brian, and at Brian Culpa Photography, he can make your imagination soar. Brian has the creative mind and tools to tell your unique story. Experience the bird's eye view at brianculpaphotography.com.
Hi, my name's Marilyn Miner, and I'm sure you'd agree that Nevada's a very special place to live. I was born here, and my husband and I have raised our family here. I feel it's a privilege to live and work in the Truckee Meadows. I especially enjoy helping my clients reach their real estate goals. Sometimes the smallest details provide the greatest satisfaction. I'd be complimented to talk to you about your next move.
Call Marilyn Miner at Dixon Realty, 742-1280, or log on to marilynminer.com.
As you know, Reno is booming. Tolls Development Company is helping it grow with insightful design and development, building community with every project, adding beauty, adding excitement, emphasizing our shared humanity. Reno is becoming bigger. Tolls Development is helping it become better, more livable, more enjoyable. To learn more, go to tollsdevelopment.com. tollsdevelopment.com.
Pro Group Management specializes in providing industries with the necessary components to satisfy and exceed workers' comp requirements. Every business has unique needs and specific regulations. Pro Group Management stays ahead of the curve, providing up-to-date services to keep your industry in top form. Discover how we simplify your tasks, improve efficiency, and reduce expense to keep you moving in a positive direction. Pro Group Management. Workers' comp that works for you.
You can now watch Nevada Newsmakers on YouTube. Just go to YouTube and search for Nevada Newsmakers and become a subscriber. We'll see you on the next broadcast. Thanks for watching and listening.